The Election Commission today ordered fresh voting in one polling station of Assam's Ratabari seat following a controversy over officials transporting electronic voting machines in the car of the BJP candidate after their own vehicle reportedly broke down. The officials involved have been suspended by the Election Commission. The car belonged to the wife of Krishnendu Paul, a BJP contestant in Patharkandi. Following the incident, there were reports of violence in the area. DMK chief MK Stalin's son-in-law was raided by income tax officials today, just 4 days before the Tamil Nadu election. Searches started around 8 a.m. at four places in Chennai owned by Sabareesan and his associates. Tax department sources told the media there were inputs on the movement of cash related to the election campaign. Sabareesan is seen as a key strategist in Stalin's core team. The searches come a day after Stalin's son Udayanidhi at a rally questioned what he called the exponential rise in the wealth of Union Home Minister Amit Shah's son Jay Shah. Three terrorists have been gunned down by security forces during an anti-terror operation in Jammu and Kashmir's Pulwama district, the police said. Two of them were involved in yesterday's attack on a BJP leader's house in Srinagar. Yesterday, one policeman was killed during a terrorist attack at BJP leader Anwar Ahmed's home at Naugam on the outskirts of Srinagar. The attackers decamped with the rifle of fallen policemen. Police said four terrorists of Lashkar-e-Taiba carried out the attack. The railway police in Uttar Pradesh's Jhansi has arrested two people in a case related to the harassment of nuns belonging to a Kerala-based congregation during a train journey last month. The district administration and police administration have detained Anchal Arjaria and Purgesh Amaria for involvement in the incident. Action will be taken against others also, a statement from the Jhansi administration said. Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray is set to chair a high-level meeting today with officials over the COVID-19 situation in the state. For a while now, Maharashtra has been reporting the highest COVID-19 caseload in India, both in terms of active coronavirus positive patients and the total number of cases.